Hello and welcome back to Tranquil IT's channel. Today we are going to go over our newest feature of WAPT, our self-service application. If you are unfamiliar with WAPT, make sure to check us out on our website or see more videos on our YouTube channel. What is our self-service application? It appeals to users and system administrators. Self-service allows users to install specific software that their system administrator has previously permitted. To start us off, we will check out our self-service in the user side, and then we will head over to our administrator side, which is managed directly in the WAPT console. So here we are in our home screen, and I will simply open our self-service application. All the user needs to do is enter in their everyday login and password that they use to access their computer. And when the self-service application opens, we're able to see all software my system administrator has authorized me to download. On our left-hand side, we can simplify our search by entering the package we're looking for example, Chrome. We can also search our packages by not installed, upgradable, and installed, as well as sort them by date, name, or category. Moving on to our packages, if we would like to install a package, all we simply have to do is click install. Removal is just as easy. All we must do is click remove. And if we would like to know more about the process of our installation, deinstallation, or update, we can simply go to our taskbar here in the bottom left, which will give us information on what is being processed in our application. As well as if I would like to know more about a package before downloading, I can simply click the plus sign in the right-hand corner, which lets me know things like the latest version, the maintainer, package size, etc. In the event that a package needs to be updated, the install button will be replaced with the update button. Now, as you can see, we have uninstalled Java, but in WAPT, everything works on the principle of dependency. And in this case, FreeMind is dependent on Java in order to satisfy the host package. Therefore, upon shutdown of the PC, WAPT is going to automatically re-download Java in order to satisfy all the dependencies in the host package. Moving on to the last great feature of our self-service application, here on the left-hand side, we are able to change the language if necessary. That pretty much covers everything from the user side of self-service. We'll now head over to the administrator side, which is managed directly in the WAPT console. So here we are on our administrator's computer, and we will simply open Active Directory to start us off. Here we can see our groups listed with our Active Directory, which at Tranquil IT we use Samba. We can see we have Information and Communication. Inside our Information group we have our members, Dark Vader and G. Bouchard. G. Bouchard is whose self-service rules we will be editing today. So headed back over to our WAPT console. If you are familiar with WAPT, you will know this home screen. If not, welcome. So to start us off, we will simply look in our software repository. Here is a list of software that we are able to deploy onto our user's PC. Although for G. Bouchard, I only want him to have availability to download a couple of these software, not all. So for this, I will head over to my self-service rules package and click create a new self-service rule. The name of this rule I'm going to call accounting because G. Bouchard works in our accounting area. And we need to give a name to our user group. Now this needs to directly align with our Active Directory group. And as we know, G. Bouchard is in our information group. So we're going to need this call this group information. And like I said, I only want him to be able to download a couple of software. For example, Thunderbird, Skype, and Notepad++. So we've created our list of available software, and I will click save. Here we can see our new self-service package has easily been created. We have the name accounting and the version number, and now we are going to deploy this onto the PC of our user G. Bouchard. So headed back to our inventory tab, here we can see our PC of G. Bouchard. We simply double click on the host. In our available packages, we will search for our accounting package that we just created using our self-service rule. We'll simply drag and drop and click save. Check for updates. And here we can see that accounting is waiting to be deployed onto our user PC of G. Bouchard. So in order to do this for the demonstration, I will force these installations by clicking apply upgrades. And in just a couple moments, we can see our accounting self-service rules package has easily been deployed onto our user G. Bouchard's PC. And there you have it, WAPT Self Service from the user and administrator side. Please feel free to leave any questions or comments in the section below. Also, make sure to check us out on our website or social media networks. We look forward to seeing you again for more videos by Tranquil IT.